We're focused on the health and safety of our member companies' employees, their communities, and their customers. That's what's driving every decision we're making right now. First, it starts with health and safety. We've got to make sure that the employees and associates that work in our plants are safe and protected, and that we start there. From there, we have to make sure that we have clear and consistent guidance on the importance of the auto industry to the US economy. As we shift from responding to the public health crisis and get ready to focus on the restart, the guidance that government gives to state and local governments, and frankly, also to our trading partners, for example, Canada and Mexico, are gonna be critically important. We put about 10,000 parts into a car. Every single one of them is essential. And so what we have to make sure is not only that the assembly plants are ready to operate, but that the suppliers that supply those plants and the suppliers that supply those suppliers are in fact ready to go. So it's an intricate and very complex set of machinery that we've got to get ready to restart. Yes, it's important that states that support auto manufacturing, and by the way, that is every state in the country. It's important that states understand their role in this critical manufacturing infrastructure. That's all critically important if we're going to get up and running. What government has to do at the federal level is to make sure that we're all aligned around that principle. So alignment between federal guidance or federal instructions about the essential nature of the auto industry have to be supported by state and local actions here in the U.S. To get the U.S. economy up and running again, we're going to have to get the U.S. auto industry up and running again. We are key to the American comeback. We are a major component to this economy. We are the largest of the manufacturing sectors in the United States. And 10 million Americans rely on us for their livelihoods.